Hey you guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. So today I'm going to be doing a love reading for the zodiac sign of Aquarius. So if you have Aquarius and you're on your birth chart, this video may resonate with you. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe and share this video, okay, with your friends, your family members, okay. And if you want to book a personal reading with me, just email me. My email is in the description box down below. So let's see what's going on for my lovely Aquariuses, Spirit Guides, the Love and Light, and Steps to the Masses, my Angel of Prayer and Light. What's going on? Ace of Cups. Ooh, the Empress. Okay, Aquarius. Okay, so you guys could be pregnant. For some of y'all been thinking that y'all could get pregnant, but you can get pregnant, and you're finna see that you can, okay? For some of y'all, I'm seeing here that y'all have to, like, do something, like, surgically to get pregnant, because it's like you've been trying to conceive, like, naturally, but it hasn't been working out for you. I'm also getting here, some of you guys could have had a miscarriage. Sorry to hear that. I'm also getting here that your baby could have been born, but it passed away. And it's like, when you get pregnant again, that baby's gonna be born on the same exact day. Like, it's like the baby's being reincarnated. That's deep. I'm also seeing here with the Empress here, you guys could be pregnant with a lot of new ideas, okay? I'm seeing here that you are very abundant, okay? You're very inspirational to others, okay? And some of you guys, y'all could have like a garden. Like, I'm seeing here, like, you eat healthy, you take care of your body, okay? You look good as fuck, okay? It's like you have high self-esteem, you're confident. Like, with the Empress here, you're in your power right now. With the Ace of Cups here, I'm seeing that you are about to get married, or you're about to enter a new romantic cycle with somebody here, now that you have grown and evolved. Now you're about to get with somebody here that's aligned with you, that share the same values and morals as you, okay? So you guys is about to get proposed to, okay? I'm also getting here, like, I don't know if you like to, like, go, like, sit on a hill or something and watch the sunset come up, or that's something that you're going to do with your lover, like, it's something that you guys just going to, like, routinely do together. Or I'm seeing here somebody here likes to hike. Somebody here likes to be out in the sun. I'm also getting here that somebody here loves to, like, go like on a patio or something, and then just like either lay on a roof or something like that and just look at the sky at nighttime with the stars shining or something like that. Oh, that is so cute. That is really cute. I would love to do that too. Okay. What else? So we have the Shrimp card here and the King of Wands. Okay. So I'm seeing here that it's somebody here from your past. They tried to keep you stuck. This person thought that they had strength over a situation with you, or they probably thought that they had power over you, like, to the point where you wasn't gonna never leave them or something. But somebody here is feeling powerless. It's like somebody here needs to have control over somebody. Like, this person is weird. Clarify the Shield card. It's like that's how somebody get bad in a day, by being able to control people. Like, what the fuck? This person is the devil. This is how the devil would think. Clarify the Shield card. And Wands in reverse. Yeah. I don't know if this person tried to confuse you to make you think that y'all are supposed to be together, or something like that. Like, somebody here is delusional. Somebody here tried to, like, destiny swap. And with the Eight of Wands in reverse, I'm seeing that this person is blocked from communicating to you, from seeing you. Okay. Because I'm seeing with the Four of Wands here, you're in a connection here, or you're about to be in a connection here with somebody that's going to be your person. Somebody that you're going to spend the rest of your life with. Okay. That you're going to build with. There's going to be peace. This person not going to have you in no drama. You know? Clarify the Hangman. Now, just like this person just stuck thinking about you. I don't know if this person, they thought it was. That's all I gotta say. They really thought it was. They thought shit was sweet. They thought that they was powerful. This person had a, that's what this person's problem is. They have a big ass ego. With the King of Wands here. And they're very manipulative, sneaky. Okay. Clarify the Hangman. Yeah, somebody had thought that you weren't going nowhere. Okay, that they just had you wrapped around their fingers. Clarify the Hangman. Three of Wands. Yeah, but you took a leap of faith. You moved away from their ass. Now somebody with Three of Wands here. They're waiting to see if you're gonna come back. They're like, is they're really moving on from me? Like, how dare they? You feel me? You're showing this person like, nigga, you was not all that. Somebody here really thought that they was all that in the bag of chips. They're not even a fucking crumb. Yeah, somebody here wanted you to be confused on which way to go. But I'm sitting here the whole time, this person thinking that you was confused, that they had one up on you, or that they was victorious in a situation here when it came to keeping you stuck. The whole time he was planning leaving their ass. Hell nah. He was already planning on making the moves to get rid of their ass. And now somebody here, they're about to see you with somebody here that's doing better than them. Okay, that's look way better than them. I don't know, like, somebody here's self-esteem is gonna crash to the fucking floor, even lower, because I already feel like this person has low self-esteem. But when they see you with this new person, this new connection, they're gonna be feeling like trash. And it's weird because this person, they need validation, they need attention, you know? Like, they don't feel good about themselves unless somebody say, oh, you look nice or something like that. Like, they need to hear compliments. And that's not good. You're supposed to know that you are that bitch inside. You're supposed to know you inside and out. You're supposed to not be looking for outside validation to make you feel good about yourself. Or try to be accepted or something. Like, somebody is a follower. And I feel like you're very authentic, unique. Okay, you don't conform to no bullshit, if it don't make sense. You're not gonna allow nobody to control you. Okay, period. You're the high fucking priestess here. You're intuitive. And it's like, I feel like you see past what people show you or tell you. You know when somebody is trying to fuck with you or be tricky or shit like that. Like, you ain't got time for none of that shit. You seeing motherfuckers. You're seeing motherfuckers. People don't know that you see past the illusion. Like, you have the spiritual gift here that some people probably don't even know that you have. And I feel like you probably keep this a secret because you don't want nobody trying to act like somebody that they're not. Like, you want people to show you their true colors. And usually people tell on themselves, you know, they don't even be realizing it. You're very observant. Yeah, I feel like you get a lot of attention. And somebody here doesn't like the fact that you get a lot of attention. Like, this person, they'd be thinking, like, since you get a lot of attention, like, you either a hoe or that you, like, you're friendly or something like that. That's because this person, they're a hoe. They're friendly. They're projecting what the fuck they are onto you. Yeah. And this person that's coming towards you, they're going to treat you fairly. The Hermit in reverse. Somebody here, they don't want to do the healing work. And I feel like that was your main reason on leaving this person behind. Somebody here, they're two-faced it, and they overindulge in third parties. Somebody here never take accountability. They always playing the victim. Okay, this person, they could hang around people here that they talk about. This person has a lot of like karmic friends and family members around them. Could I have the justice? And I'm sitting here, due to the fact that you are a high priestess and you have these spiritual gifts, it's like you get yourself out of a lot of situations where people that's 3D based stay in. You know? Like you see a lot of shit that a lot of people don't see because they're so 3D. You know? We have the sun, yeah. That's like the justice. And I feel like your justice is being happy, being at peace, celebrating, experiencing joy, okay? And somebody here is upset, they're burdened, okay? And it could be because something came out here that they didn't want to come out. Somebody here was going to take this to the grave with them. Or something came out here of this person being unfair to you. Somebody here was playing dumb. Like somebody here could have told you like, you know, I'm going to help you, like just be patient with me. But they knew that they wasn't ever going to help you. This person didn't want you to think that so you could keep giving to them. You know, they wanted you to keep giving to them. They wanted you to think like, oh, like this person's going to eventually help me. Like they got my back. You know, they would never betray me. They would never do no shiesty shit behind my back the whole time they was. And that came out. And I feel like somebody here is receiving karma. And whatever that they took from you, that shit has come back to you 10 times more. This person, they don't have shit. That's why they're looking stupid as fuck. This person with the 10 of wands here, they hold on to pain and trauma. And somebody here is trying to act like they're happy and they're not. They're getting their ass beat by karma. It's fucking this person up. This person's insides is boiling. And that's because with the Hermit in reverse, somebody here is, they don't want to do no soul searching, self introspection. They don't want to do that. They want to keep being in karmic energy, so shit. They're going to meet somebody here that's real karmic. That's going to get this person a run for their money. Trying to make you mad or trying to get over you instead of doing the healing work and get hopping in another commitment, they're going to meet somebody here. Just like they ass. A fool. Yeah, the stuff right here. A lot of eyes are on you, okay? You could do something here in the public eye for work. And you help people. A lot of people listen to your advice. And you help people get out of situations that don't want to serve them and help them heal traumas and help them, you know, with shit that they probably never thought of by the words that you're saying. Like you help people look deeper into situations. You help people look at the bigger picture of shit. And it's like this person, they hold on to you. Mm-hmm. They will never let you go, like ever. Three of Wands. Clarify the Temperance. Yeah, somebody here is watching you and they're seeing like how cool you is. Like, like you don't look stressed out. This person, you see this person, they look crazy as fuck. Like they look like life is beating their ass. And when somebody here look at you, it looks like, whoa, like they look like they enjoying life. They're not worried about me. They look like they got their shit together. Clarify the Temperance. And this person, I feel lost here. I don't know what they're waiting on. This person, they procrastinate a lot. Like they need to start moving, taking action. This person, they just sit on their ass and just think all day. clarify the Temperance. We have the New Moon and the King of Pentacles. Yeah. Like, you're not allowing the situation to fuck up your future in the now. You learned your lesson. That's experience is in the past. And you're on to something bigger and better, period. I don't know if this person thought that what they did to you was going to just affect you and you was going to stay in a bitter energy because they're bitter. They don't know how to move away from situations here, okay, and heal from it that wasn't good for them. They just go and, you know, fuck with other people that didn't do them no harm, and they, you know, fuck with these people, self-esteem, confidence. You know, this person wants you to feel how they feel. And I feel like they didn't succeed at that. They probably did in the beginning, but not for long. Somebody here is looking dumb as hell, period. Clarify the Three of Wands. The Lovers. Clarify the Three of Wands. Knight of Swords. Give me no Clarify the Three of Wands. King of Swords. Yeah, this person, they're in this energy where it's like they're acting like they don't care. Where for some of y'all, I feel like they probably don't care. Okay. Cause they can't care if they're acting like this. If you cared enough, you would fix yourself. This person, they're not trying to fix themselves. It's like when they sit by themselves, they just have these negative thoughts and they let it like just take over them. This person always thinks that somebody here is after them. They're easily get defensive. This person, they could be paranoid. And they're so busy thinking about who you're dealing with, who you're talking to, who's taking up your time, your energy. And they feel like you're gonna forget about them, okay? And I feel like now, since you cut them off, this person, they're finna, whoever they're gonna be dealing with, they finna ruin this person. They're like, oh, you wanna leave me? You wanna go talk to somebody else? All right, I'm finna just fuck up everybody's life. I'm just finna fuck with everybody. King of Swords. Yeah, this person, their heart chakra is closed off. Yep, all because Eight of Cups, you left. You're not returning. This person really is hoping and praying that you're returning. I feel like they're actually pissed at themselves because they're thinking about the shit they've done to you. Probably that you probably don't know about. But I feel like you do know about it. But this person, I think they probably know that you could be intuitive. And they probably wonder, like, how much shit do you know? You know? I feel like that scares them. Like, that makes them nervous to, like, approach you. So it's like they're waiting for you to reach out. You know? But you're not going to reach out to this person. I feel like they could be in your energy heavy. But you're not going to reach out to them. I don't see that. So let's see. These are some messages that this person wants to tell Aquarius, Spirit Guides, of a Light, Ancestors, and Masters, the Angel of Power and Night. This person thought that they was going to get some type of victory out of the shit that they were doing to you. Like, this person, I don't know if they don't believe in karma or something. Like, they just think that they're supposed to do crazy shit to people and they're, like, just supposed to just be normal. And they supposed to just receive all these blessings or some shit like that. Like, no, nigga, you finna get that karma. Like, people be slow. Yeah, we were seeing someone better and you guys gonna be a power couple. And this person, they're gonna be pissed. Like, they did all that for what? People be thinking they gonna win in the end by doing this to people. You're not gonna win in the end. It's hate never wins. We have, how am I supposed to replace you? Yeah, this person probably tried to replace you, but they don't like whoever that they tried to replace you with. Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn could be significant here. My person is jealous of you. Yeah, it could have been somebody here, and this person is so jealous of you. This person they hate your guts. This person, they know that this person is still in love with you. They're paying attention to you. They're trying to see what is this person like about you, bitch. Ask them. Friends with benefits. So this person couldn't want to be friends with benefits with you. Or something is gonna turn to friends with benefits, but it's gonna turn to something serious. You didn't deserve that. Yeah, I'm too prideful to admit that I miss you. Yeah, so they have to put on this poker face like they don't give a fuck, you know? But I feel like you already know. That's the High Priestess. You already know. Like, this person don't have to tell you nothing. You already fucking know. Yeah, they did something to you, and they feel bad for what they did. I'm afraid that I don't have enough to offer you. Yeah, this person, they feel like they don't have enough to offer you. They actually feel like you're out of their league. I miss the sound of your voice. Let me show you that I'm different. I want to hold you again. So it could be somebody here that's new that want to show you that they're different. You could have told this person, like, you know, the shit that you dealt with, you know. Y'all probably could relate. Y'all probably had the same situations. And they want to show you that they're different. Somebody here wants to hold you. What else? Please just let me explain. You should be with me instead. Yeah, somebody here don't want you to be with this person. And I feel like this person wants you to be with them instead, but you like, hell no. They want to explain to you what the fuck, why they did what they did. I act like I don't care, but I'm really obsessed with you. Yeah. And I feel like you walked away and you let go of this person. Yeah, they don't just say this. Like, this is confirmation, that type of confirmation. But I hope this video gave guys a lot of clarity. If it did, don't forget to like this video, comment, and subscribe. And I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.